This is the book of 2nd Ezra chapter 9 and verse 14. And it says, it reads, "Then answer I and said, I have said before, and now do speak, and I will speak it also hereafter, that there be many more of them which perish than of them which shall be saved, like as a wave is greater than a drop." All right. Barakat Yahweh, Barakat Yahweh Shai. All right. Barakat Yahweh, Barakat Yahweh Shai, Barakat Yahweh, Barakat Yahweh Shai. All right. First and foremost, I want to give all praises, all honor, and all glory unto Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rechakwadash. All right. I want to give double honors to my apostles and elders at Great Millstone, which rule well. And I want to give a peace, greetings, and salutations to all the Legakim that's pushing this word in truth and sincerity, you know, throughout the four corners of the earth, you know, and the brothers that's not wavering in the faith, you know, being diligent in the truth. You know, I say shalom to you, brothers, you know, and I say shalom, you know, to the few sisters that believe in all meekness and humbleness. You know, I say shalom. You know, I'm your brother Zakaria from GMS Miami Camp. And our Lord willing, you know, through the spirit and power of Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh, Bahashem, Recha, Kodash, you know, Adawan Rataza, you know what I mean? Lord willing, you know, so Lord willing, this lesson is edifying to the elect of the nation Israel, you know. And my lesson today, you know, through the spirit and power of Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh, Bahashem, Recha, Kodash, is going to be based on this precept that I just read, 2nd Ezra chapter 9 and verse 15. I'll read it again. It says, "I have said before and now do speak, and I will speak it also hereafter, that there be many more of them which perish than of them which shall be saved," man. All right, so it's going to be more people that perish, all right, than those that be saved, man. All right, the scriptures say in the Bible, all right, when our Lord returns, all right, bear with me. When the Lord returns, the slain of the Lord is going to be many. This book of Isaiah chapter 66, verse 15 says, "For behold, the Lord will come with fire." This is our Lord Yahweh Shah, who the world ignorantly called Jesus Christ, a so-called black man. All right, he's coming back with the holy host of angels, man. All right, the host. Scripture said Daniel the 12th chapter, Michael the archangel is gonna come with him, man. All right, with thousands of his saints, as it said in the book of Jude, man. It says, "For behold, the Lord would come with fire and with his chariots like a whirlwind, to render his anger with fury and his rebuke with flames of fire. For by fire and by his sword would the Lord plead with all flesh," meaning judge all flesh, "and the slain of the Lord shall be many." So a lot of people, all right, is going to perish in these times. The slain of the Lord is going to be many. All right, a lot of people are going to get put to death, all right, in these last days, man. All right, this is the book of Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 8. Bear with me. What second Ezra's 8? Let's see. Bear with me. So, 2nd Ezra 8. This book is 2nd Ezra chapter 8 in verse 1. All right. 2nd Ezra chapter 8 in verse 1. It says, "And he answered me, saying, the Most High hath made this world for many, but the world to come for few." All right. The Lord is about to delete a lot of people, man. All right. The Lord is about to delete a lot of people. And if you're not a part of the elect of the nation of Israel, you hearing the souls of America, which is Babylon the Great. If you're not part of the elect, you're going to get put to death. What he says, like 300 million people here. All right. The Lord is only going to deliver the elect of Israel. So the majority of these people, they're going to burn by thermonuclear fire. All right. From intercontinental ballistic missiles from Russia, Iran, China, North Korea. All right, all these nations that have nuclear capability, even America's own ally is going to shoot missiles against this place, man. All right. The slain of the Lord is going to be many, man. All right. I'm going to jump down to verse 3. It says, "There be many created, but few shall be saved." All right, it's only on a few amount of people, all right, it's going to be saved compared to the majority of the world, man. The Lord's not dealing with the whole world. He's only dealing with Israel, right? The world of Israel, the cosmos of Israel. But in these times, the elect, the Israel of the Most High, he's not even dealing with majority of his people, man. All right, this is the book of 2nd Ezra, so I'm gonna stay in 2nd Ezra, the 5th chapter though. 2nd Ezra chapter 5 verse 1, it says, "Nevertheless, as coming the tokens," but if you read in the actual book form copy, it says, "as concerning the tokens as concerning the tokens are not coming. It says, nevertheless, as concerning the tokens, meaning the signs, behold, the day shall come that they which dwell upon earth shall be taken in a great number. That meaning mass death. So people are going to be taken in a great number. It says, the days come that they which dwell upon earth shall be taken in a great number, and the way of truth shall be hidden. Why? Because it's going to be a famine of the word, man. All right. That's why the Lord says, seek him while he may be found, call upon him while he is near. All right. But our people, they're going to wait till it's too late, and they're going to be looking for the prophets, and hey, you're not going to find us, man. Lord willing, we are part of that elect number. All right. They're going to ask, what do we do now? No. We're not playing that game. All right. Apostles and elders been out for decades, man. Hey, go to him that sell, as scripture talk about the ten virgins, five were wise, five was kind of like y'all had a phone call. But we're gonna continue going in the spirit, man. Yeah, the famine of the word coming, man. So let's read this again. It's a second letter chapter 5, verse 1. It says, nevertheless, as concerning the tokens, behold, the day shall come that they which dwell upon earth shall be taken in a great number, meaning mass death. It says, in the way of truth shall be hidden, the famine of the word, man. All right, there's a such thing as too late, man. As I was going into the ten virgins, five were wise, five was foolish. All right, the wise ones gonna have that, or they're gonna have the wisdom, knowledge, understanding. All right, it says, in the land shall be barren of faith, because these people, they're gonna show their faithless. That's why they're gonna go to Esau for help, and Esau gonna give them that MOTB, and they're gonna be destroyed, man. Verse 2, it says, but iniquity shall be increased, meaning sin upon sin, above that which now thou seest or that thou hast heard long ago. And the land that thou seest now to have root, shall thou see wasted suddenly, man. All right. This place has root, but it's going to be wasted. All right. 200 million nuclear warheads, also laser fire, is going to destroy this place, man. All right, if you're not a part of the elect, you're going to be destroyed right along in this place, man. This is the book of Malachi chapter 4, verse 1. It says, for behold, the day cometh that shall burn as an oven, meaning the day of the Lord. It says, and all the proud, and yea, and all that do wickedly shall be stubble, man. And that's the majority of these people. They're proud and they do wickedly. All right, so they're going to be stubble. It says, and that day... So in the day that cometh shall burn them up, saith the Lord of hosts, saith Yahweh Shemashai, that it shall leave them neither root nor branch, man. So a lot of people gonna get burnt in these times, man. This is the book of Zephaniah chapter 2 and verse 1. It says, gather yourselves together, yea, gather together, O nation not desired. Alright, but who's ultimately gonna gather and come back to the Lord? The elect. Before the decree bring forth, before the day pass as the chaff, before the fierce anger of the Lord come upon you, before the day of the Lord's anger come upon you. Because what? The day of the Lord is going to be darkness and not light. All right. A day of wrath. A day of gloominess. Verse 3. Seek ye the Lord, all ye meek of the earth, which have wrought his judgment. Seek righteousness. Seek meekness. It may be ye shall be hid in the day of the Lord's anger. So we want to be hid in the day of the Lord's anger, man. It's book of Isaiah chapter... He's 26. Yeah, 26 and 20. Isaiah chapter 26 and verse 20 says, come, my people, this is the elect of Israel, enter thou into thy chambers, meaning the Lord's going to beam the elect up in the chariots, so-called UFOs, and shut thy doors about thee, hide thyself as it were for a little moment until the end of nation be overpassed, until the Lord's righteous anger be overpassed, man. Lord said he going to shake the heavens. All right, and the earth going to reel to and fro like a drunkard, man. Verse 21 says, for behold, the Lord cometh out of his place to punish the inhabitants of the earth for their iniquities. So a lot of people going to get punished for their sins. The earth also shall disclose her blood and shall no more cover her slain. So the Lord said he's going to come out of his place to destroy the inhabitants of the earth. What? Ultimately, he's going to send what our Lord Yahushua back. All right. All right, to gather the elect and what destroy a lot of people, man. All right, this is the book of Scripture say the righteous shall scarcely be saved, man. It's 1 Peter 4:7-18. Yeah. 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 17. It says, for the time has come that judgment must begin at the house of the Most High. Now, a lot of these Israelites that know they're Israelites, they're going to get put to death too. Should say, on the day of the Lord, they're going to say, Lord, Lord, meaning Yahushai, Yahushai, we've done many miracles. We cast out devils. But the Lord said, the Lord's going to say unto them, I don't know you. Depart from me, ye that work iniquity, man. All right. And judgment going to begin at those who know they Israelites, man. It says and if it first begin at us, what shall be the end of them that obey not the gospel of the Most High? Verse 18. And if the righteous scarcely be saved, where shall the ungodly and sinner appear? So the righteous is going to be scarcely saved, but the rest, how are they going to appear? All right, being destroyed, man. Revelation 11 and verse 12, it says, and they heard a voice from heaven saying unto them, come up hither. So this is the elect being called up in the chariot, so-called UFO, saying, come up hither in the Hebrew. And they ascended up to heaven in a cloud, and their enemies beheld them. Their enemies, all right? These heathens and what? Two-thirds of our people. It says, and in the same hour, there was a great earthquake. That earthquake, talking about those missiles. When the missiles hit, it's going to real shake the earth, man. It says, and the 10th part of the city fell. This is talking about Babylon the Great, because what? FEMA has America, all right, in what? 10 regions, all right? So the whole part of America going to fall. It says, and in the earthquake was slain of men 7,000, meaning a complete amount of men, women and children going to be slain, man. And the remnant were frightened, talking about the elect. They was frightened when they got beamed up. It says, and gave glory to the power of heaven. Gave glory to Yahweh Shemashah. Verse 14, the second woe is past, and behold, the third woe cometh quickly. All right, the third woe is coming quickly. The second woe has passed. Talking about World War I, World War II, and what the third war is worse, coming quickly. Verse 15, it says, and the seventh angel sounded, and there were great voices in heaven, saying, the kingdoms of this world are become the kingdoms of our Lord and of his anointing, and he shall reign forever and ever. So this is ultimately going to happen, because what the Lord is about to reign, all right, and what he's going to gather his elect from the four corners of the earth. The scripture said they're going to be weeping and gnashing the teeth, man. All the tribes of the earth shall mourn, all right, when they see the Lord come, because right, what? He's going to destroy a lot of people. We just read Isaiah 66 and verse 15. All right, not everybody's going to be saved, man. Only the elect of Israel, all right, is going to be delivered, man. All right, out of Babylon the Great. All right, this book I'll end off on this, Zechariah chapter 13 and verse 8. And it shall come to pass that in all the land, talking about here in America, saith the Lord, two parts therein shall be cut off and die. Meaning two-thirds of the nation Israel here in America are going to be cut off and die. But the third shall be left in, talking about the elect. The elect is going to be delivered. The one third. All right, because what, you got 144,000. All right, then you got a one third here in America. Well, then you got the rest of the elect that's scattered, man. All right, verse 9, it says, and I will bring the third part through the fire, talking about the elect, and refine them as silver is refined, and will try them as gold is tried. They shall call on my name, and I will hear them. I will say, it is my people, and they shall say, the Lord is my power. That's the elect, man. All right, so a lot of people going to perish, but a few shall be saved. And we pray we are part of that number, man. All right, on that great day, it says, many are called. All right, Matthew chapter 20, verse 16 says, so the last shall be first, and the first shall be last. For many be called, but few chosen. Matthew 22 and 14, for many are called, but few are chosen, man. And who's also being the chosen? The elect, the ones who was predestined for the nation Israel from the beginning, all right, to receive salvation and to be glorified when our Lord Yahushua is glorified. All right, first he got to get his glory. Then what? Lord, when you pray, we're going to get our glory, man. But a lot of people are going to die. Majority of these people in Babylon the Great are going to get put to death, man, because they walk in great pride. She would say, great misery shall come upon these people, because they have walked in great pride, all right? So, Lord, when in this lesson was edifying to the elect of the nation of Israel, you know, I want to give all praises, all honor, and all glory unto Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rechakodash. All right, I want to give double honors to my apostles and elders at Great Millstone, which rule well. And I want to give a peace and greetings and salutations to all the Lekakim, That's pushing his word in truth and sincerity. Hey, Shalom, Mike M. Keep pushing. Keep it doing. Shalom.